Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 2021, highlight all formulas. I am podcasting this entire book. Click in the top right hand corner up there to get to the playlist. All right, episode 26B. This is even one of the 40 tips, right? I say the XL on the front of the cover is for the Roman numeral of 40, and that there's 40 tips in the book, but that is such an unexaggeration, because there's far more than 40 tips. Like this little bonus tip, like yesterday, I showed you how to use Ctrl and the grob accent to see all the formulas at once, you know, but that's a really temporary thing. What if we need to go audit all those formulas? First thing we do is we select all of the cells. I use this little icon up here. I know some people use Ctrl A and that works unless you're in a table, blah, 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 blah. All right, anyway, so we select all cells, and then, oh, geez, the book tells you to go to home, find and select, go to special, select formulas, and I've been doing that over and over and over and over. Go to special. And finally, I was doing a seminar, one of my live Power Excel seminars recently, and I noticed that right underneath go to special is something called formulas. And while go to special is amazing, it offers all kinds of amazing things like formulas that are errors or constants that are numbers or blank cells or visible cells only. I use those over and over and over again. I had to admit that home, find and select, and formulas is just the much, much easier way to go. All right, so hey, first off, look at this. Instantly, you can tell that that number, which all the other numbers in the column are formulas, that number, for some reason, is hard-coded. All right, that's a problem. This number, which should be not a formula, is a formula for some reason. All right, so if we had to go through and audit each one of these, we would want to do something to change these formula cells, like maybe apply some sort of a color, or heck, we can even go to cell styles. There's a calculation out here, right? The ugly orange on the gray background, something, so that way you can go through and find these one at a time. All right, so now once we've found these, well, what can you do? One thing you can do is select the cell that has the formula and go to the formulas tab and ask for trace precedents. All right, now this is one of those features that makes it into the afternoon seminar, right? It's not one of my top 40 tips, so it's not in the book. This tip's not in the book. But what I really, really love about this book is after I got done with the book and my 40 tips and Sylvia's 20 tips and then another 10 tips for I don't know, and 40 Excel shortcut keys, I went through all of the tips that people tweeted to me. Right, and I went through all these tweets, hundreds of tweets, and I made sure that I included people's tips, and there was a list of 40 tips at the end that didn't make it into the book, right? But they were tips that were self-explanatory in a 140 character tweet, all right? And so on page 223 and 224 of the book, I put in 40 tips that aren't in the book, and now, hey, they're in the book, right? So those aren't counted at all. They're not in the 40 or the bonus 30 or the extra bonus tips. And so as I was thinking about this, I remember there was a great tip there from two just giants in the Excel world, Sean Blessed and David Ringstrom. Both have great Twitter feeds, fascinating to watch their Twitter feeds. And they said, turn off edit directly in a cell, then double click a formula to show cells used in that formula, even if they're in an external workbook. All right, so how do we do this? We go to File, and then Options, go to the huge Advanced tab, but it's right here on the first one, allow editing directly in cells. So I remember back when you had to build the formulas in the formula bar, and all of a sudden they allowed us to build the formulas right in the cell. That was a big thing. That was a selling feature back in like Excel, I don't know, 95 or somewhere, a long time ago. Now what I can do is select that formula. See, that formula is referring to four cells. When I double click, those four cells become highlighted as a group, and the first one, D6, is selected. And you might know this. When you have cells, multiple cells selected, pressing Enter moves to the next cell in the group, right? So I just selected all four precedent cells, and now I can go investigate those one at a time by pressing Enter, even if they're on different sheets or in different workbooks. Isn't that a beautiful tip, right? Not one of my top 40, but still a beautiful tip. Those two pages in the book are just a cool, cool two pages, because they're tips that aren't in my seminar, but are still awesome Excel tips, and I'm happy and honored that a lot of people contributed tips to this book. All right, well, if you're watching this on the day it came out, it's Friday, it's payday. You can get the whole book, the ebook, for 10 bucks, about £5. Just a great deal. Go click that I in the top right hand corner And you'll have all of these tips, my tips, other people's tips, keyboard shortcuts, great collection of Excel knowledge. All right, episode recap. We want to show how to highlight all the formula cells in the spreadsheet. Select all cells. I use this icon up here, north or west of A1. Some people use Ctrl A. Home, find and select formulas. That tip's even better than the tip in the book where it said find and select go to special formulas. And then once you have the cells, all the formulas selected, use a cell style, a font style, a fill color, whatever you need to do so that we can highlight those. Look for things that should be formulas that are not. I showed you how to use trace precedents, a tip that's not in the book. And one of those 40 tips that I said wasn't in the book, but that I put them in the book anyway, turn off edit directly in cells, double click, it selects all the precedent cells, and then you can just press enter to move from item to item to item. Well, hey, thanks to David and Sean for that last tip, and thanks to you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.